Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous video of the various criteria for the congruence of triangles, we discussed the angle side angle congruence rule. Today, we will discuss the angle angle side AAS criterion for the congruence of triangles. Friends, we know that the sum of the three angles of any triangle is 180 degrees. So, if the two angles of any two triangles are equal, then the third angle will also be equal. So, if the three angles of any two triangles are equal, then can we call those triangles congruent? No, because we can make many triangles that have three equal angles, but not three equal sides. These may be identical, but not congruent. Therefore, we can say that for any two triangles to be congruent, their three angles being equal is not sufficient. But if any one of their sides are equal, then the triangles made will be similar. Therefore, these triangles will be congruent according to the ASA congruent rule. If we are not given any information about this angle, then how can we check the congruence of these two triangles? We can clearly see here that angle A is equal to angle T, angle B is equal to angle R. And if we are given that side BC is equal to side RS or side CA is equal to side ST, then these two triangles can be said to be congruent by the AAS congruence criterion. That's why we can say that in any two triangles, if two pairs of angles are equal and one pair of their corresponding sides are equal, then the two triangles are said to be congruent. We call this the angle-angle side criterion, that is the AAS congruence rule. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed the angle-angle side AAS congruence rule for triangles. See you in the next video. Thank you.